Back at the castle, Thomas and his friends were working together again.
Easy, Percy!
Sorry, I didn't mean to wobble.
Calm down and pay attention.
You both need to pay attention.
Then there was trouble.
Thomas, stop!
Luckily, no one was hurt.
Is everyone all right?
I am.
I'm not. My paintwork is covered in dust. I need to go to the washdown.
You can't go to the washdown now, James. We need to carry on with our work, or the castle won't be ready in time.
And I suppose my paintwork's not important.
Paxton and Diesel were very surprised to see Stephen turn up at Brendan Docks.
Who is that old-fashioned engine with the wooden boiler, Paxton?
I don't know. Shall I ask him?
Don't bother. Out of the way, little steamy. We have work to do here.
Well, so do I, Mr. Oily.
It's Mr. Oily.
Stephen's the name. I'm looking for my new job.
Here? At Brendan Docks? Are you sure?
This is no place for an old engine like you.
Cranky's right, old timer. Best keep out of the way and let the modern engines get on with their work.
Sorry, Stephen. Nice to meet you.
Poor Stephen felt disappointed. But if his new job wasn't at Brendan Docks, he'd just have to continue on his quest to find it. After the accident was cleared away, Thomas and his friends worked hard to complete the roof. At last, the final beam was put into place. The job was done.
Marvelously together. Soon everything will be ready for the big surprise.
I bet I know what it is. Are you the King of Sodor, sir?
No, Percy. I'm not the King of Sodor.
Oh? Then what is the surprise?
Come outside and I'll show you.
And then can I go to the washdown, sir?
Of course you can, James. Of course you can.
Stephen was heading up to the Blue Mountain Quarry.
There's always plenty of work for extra engines in a quarry.
But the Blue Mountain Quarry was much bigger and noisier than any quarry Stephen had ever seen before.
Hello! My name's Luke. Who are you?
I'm Stephen. I'm looking for my new job. Could it be here?
Well, I'm not sure, really.
We can always use another engine. But are you really strong enough for this kind of work?
Strong? I used to pull 4 wagons at a time when I worked at the mines. Give me a chance and you'll see. I want to be really useful again.
Okay, then. No harm in that.
Stephen was coupled to a long line of trucks, loaded with slate.
Take it away, Stephen!
But they were too heavy. The men uncoupled one of the trucks, and Stephen tried again. And again. And again. Until Stephen finally managed to pull one truck forward.
There we go! I told you I could do it! Now watch how fast I can go!
Be careful on the corner, Stephen!
Look out!
But it was too late. As Stephen came to the bend, the heavy truck pushed him forward and nearly ran him off the rails.
wagons I pulled at the mines weren't as heavy as the ones you have here. They were a lot smaller, too. Do you know of any mines around here?
Oh, well, there used to be an old mine near Alfstead Castle ruins, but, I don't think anyone works there anymore.
Oh, maybe I'll take a look for myself. Goodbye.
Stephen's quest to find his new job was not over yet. Back at the Earl's estate, Thomas, James and Percy were amazed to see what was inside the Earl's crates. There were thrones and catapults, flags and tapestries, old statues, shields and suits of armour from all over the world.
Look, Thomas, more metal men. Thomas, that one's moving. It's alive.
I think you'll find it has a helping hand, Percy.
It's all part of my big surprise. I am reopening Alfstead Castle to the public. Visitors will come from far and wide to see my collection of medieval treasures.
And the king's golden crown?
Ah, no, Thomas. Sadly, the only thing missing is King Godred's golden crown.
But guess what, Thomas? Your friend Stephen is going to be the castle's guide.
Oh, that's right. You can tell Stephen about his new job now if you want to, Thomas.
And can I go to the washdown now?
Oh, yes, James. Of course you can. Oh, bother. I still need you three to take all those troublesome trucks away.
Hero was very happy to be coming back to Sodor from the mainland. Oh, my! James was very happy to be having a washdown. When?
What was that?
Gordon and Spencer were very happy to be racing each other again. When?
Who was that? Don't ask me. I never see.
The two speedy engines were waiting at a red signal. They were both streamlined like Spencer.
Hello there. I'm Connor.
And I'm Caitlin. We've come for the opening of Alfstead Castle to bring passengers from the mainland.
This is our test run and time trial. We're having a little race. Care to join us?
Well, I have to get back to Knapford, actually, as I'm afraid I have work to do too. Ha, we never race. No, we're far too busy for racing.
Sit yourselves!
Stephen was on the slope below the castle when he noticed the track to the old mine.
Right, this may well be my last chance. Best try to make a good show of myself.
Stephen made his way along the overgrown track. But when he finally reached the entrance to the mine, he found it was boarded up.
It's true. Nobody works here anymore. Oh, Thomas was wrong. There isn't a job for me anywhere. I'm too slow, old and weak.
Thomas and Percy were ready to push the troublesome trucks loaded with dirt away. The Earl thought they were too heavy for two small engines alone.
I must call Sir Topham. I'll ask him to send James back to help.
But Thomas didn't want to wait for James to come back.
I'm sure Percy and I can manage, sir.
He wanted to tell Stephen all about his new job.
Hold on, Thomas. Shouldn't one of us be at the front? What happens when we get to the top of the slope?
But it was troublesome trucks were already on the slope. They started to pull forward, dragging Thomas and Percy behind them.
Fingers and dashes!
The troublesome trucks were too heavy to stop. Stephen was now trapped in the mine. The island of Sodor was buzzing with excitement about the grand opening of Ulfstead Castle. Visitors were hurrying across from the mainland to be there. Engines were working hard to make sure everything was ready. Thomas went to the steamworks to find Stephen.
Hello, Victor. Where's Stephen?
I don't know, Thomas. He left in quite a hurry. He kept asking about his new job.
His new job? He didn't even know what it was. Where could he have gone?